I'm Sophie, and I'm also a PhD student at the section of statistics and data analysis. And my PhD project is about multiplicative mixed models, and I mainly apply them to data from sensory science and data from agriculture. So what is a multiplicative mixed model? It is an extension of a normal linear mixed model, but here we also have a multiplicative term added. And here we define a multiplicative term as a term as a product of a random effect and a fixed effect. And what we gain from using these multiplicative models instead of the linear mixed models is that instead of assuming that the interaction is random and normally distributed, we now model the interaction by linear regression. So this is how the model can look like in the frame of agricultural studies. More specifically, we are looking at genotype by environment data. So we have eye plants with different genotypes that are grown in different environments, and then we measure the yield of the plant or the height of the plant, for instance. So the yield, for instance, can be our response. And in this setup, we are interested in the different environments. So therefore, our environments are the fixed effect because we want to compare different environments and see which environments are better to grow the different plants. So therefore, we have in our model the random effect of the different genotypes, the fixed effect of the different environments, and then we have this multiplicative term added, which is a regression term. So the B's here are the genotype-specific regression slopes, and then we regress on the environments. And we do this because the different genotypes might have different sensitivities to the environments. And that is what the multiplicative term here accounts for. Another situation where we can use this model is in the field of sensometrics that Federica just talked about. So we have these eye assessors or judges that scores different products and k-replicates. It can be food, for instance, cheese, as Federica talked about. It can also be televisions, for instance, that different assessors are looking at, and then they're judging how bright the picture is or how clear the picture is. For instance, this is the data I will look at in 1 minute. So here, we're interested in comparing the different products, so therefore the products are our fixed effects, so therefore we have here the fixed effect of the product and the random effect of the different assessors, and then we have here the multiplicative term, where this time now the regression coefficient is dependent on the different assessors. And the reason for using this model in this type of data is that the multiplicative term accounts for the different use of the scale that these assessors are doing, because for instance when the different assessors are scoring the product, then some of the assessors might use a larger part of the scale than the other assessors, and this I will illustrate with these plots. So here is a television data set that I just described shortly, and I've chosen these two different assessors because they score the products very differently. Because as you see here, assessor 2 uses a super small part of the scale to distinguish between the products. Here are the 12 products and these are the scores, and we have two replicates. And here is assessor 7 that uses a way larger part of the scale to distinguish between these products. So how do we estimate this multiplicative mixed model? And we do that by using my R package, of course, which is called MOM, which stands for multiplicative mixed models. And for those of you who work with linear mixed models, you will see that the syntax of my package is very similar to the syntax of LMER. So you have this this part which is very similar to the linear case, but then also we have this multiplicative term added, and also the output here is very similar to for the to the linear case. So we have the estimates of our fixed effects here and the estimates of the variance components. And we can also find the random effects. And here are the A's in the model, the assessor effects. And here are the regression slopes. And before I showed you the scores given by SSA2 and SSA7, and we saw that SSA2 uses a very small part of the scale, which is why this assessor have a small and negative regression coefficient. And here SSA7 have a large one instead. And I have plotted the scores for SSA2 and 7 again with the fitted regression lines. And here we see as expected that because SSA7 is using a big part of the scale, he will also have, he or she, will also have a steep regression line compared to this SSA2. And we see this, a similar situation here with the, where I've chosen to plot some data from an agricultural study where I look at the height of some plants. And then I have chosen the first two genotypes, where we see here that genotype 2, the blue line, is more sensitive to the environment, which is why the height is more dependent on the environment effect here. So we also see a steep regression line compared to genotype 1. And the take-home message from my small presentation here is that this multiplicative model can be useful in every situation where we have an interaction between a fixed effect and a random effect. And we use it to get a better interpretation of the interaction and improve statistical inference if the multiplicative term is significant. And if it's not significant, then we can use the model to validate the linear mixed model to see that the linear model is sufficient.
And thank you.
Use my arm.
Yeah. And use my arm.